Okay, hi, I'm back. Just wanted to show somebody had a question regarding DaVinci Resolve. Can you export multiple still images once you've worked on them for color grading? You really can, and there's several different ways of doing it. So I have a blank timeline here, and I'm going to just import a bunch of images. Now, if you shoot with the black magic, pretty much any black magic camera, and you shoot stills from that. And I'm referring to the black magic pocket 4K, which I happen to have. And you can basically just drag like all of those clips right to the timeline. I'm gonna change and allow it to modify the timeline here for a second. And what it does here in this case is it takes all the clips and makes them single frame images. So I'm going to change a couple of settings here. I'm going to go into my corner. I'm going to change this color management because when I'm working with images and I want the best color range or the color mode, color management, I want to sit there and actually use it in both have DaVinci YRGB color managed, and then the HDR DaVinci wide gamut interface. So that you can use for SDR and HDR video if you know what that's about. That also pertains to still images and raw photos and things like that. So what that does is it instantly took B-RAW images and made them, as you can see here, crisp. And that's where you would go into your settings here later on. And you would go clip, and then it's shot in that. So I'm taking the first clip. I want highlight recovery. And I'm going to turn off gamma compression. Don't need that. Highlight recovery allows you to recover anything in the highlights. And you can select all of these. You can take the middle mouse button and click on that first one, and it will replace all of those so that they have the same setting. You went to decode clip, ISO 200, highlight recovery. So now that's applied to every single one of those. Then it's just a matter of individually going through and color grading them however you wish. Now, the problem comes to export. How can I export this? So, and there's actually quite a few ways of doing this. I can go through each and every single one of these. So this is if I put it in the stills area in my gallery, stills, but this gallery is for this particular timeline. And what you do is once you get your color grade, all your notes done and everything else, the image here in the center is going to represent that, the color grade that you applied. Then you're just going to right click on it, call grab still, and you're going to do that for each and every single one. So grab still, and again, this is after you've color graded and you've got all those done. So grab still. Then in here in the stills images, if you select, so hold down the shift key and select the last one, it selects them all. Right click on it, call go to export. Give them a particular file that you would want to file format, PNG, JPEG, whatever. And then just hit export, and all of a sudden it will populate all those files properly. So you can see here it exports those. I've got other ones in here. Let's go by date added. So we have DRX files. That's annoying. They're valuable, but they're unnecessary for stills export. For the majority of people, we don't need those. You can just sit there. You can go like this. You go into kind, and then they'll all be put in their proper place, and then just select them and delete them. They're unnecessary for the majority of people. You don't need them. But all of the stills are exported that way. So you have them nice and clean in whatever manner you need. So that's one way of getting them all done accordingly. Now, if you happen to have, I'm going to go into another thing here. I'm going to select these and get rid of them. That's with B-RAW files. What happens if you grab a bunch of JPEGs or a bunch of raw photos and things like that, and I just drag them to the timeline. Okay, well, I just did that. Boom. Now, look. So I'm going to zoom back out on this timeline. You can see, okay, they've added like what, the 5 second, 10 second setup on that. That's annoying. So were I to go through here and color grade each and every one, I could still do that export that way. But let's say I wanted to actually export it through the deliver page. What I'll do is I will select them all. This is just another option. This is just another way of doing things. The other way works perfectly fine. So this way, what I'm going to do is I'm going to compress them into a timeline. I'm going to make that single frame. And that's the process here. So we go here, select them all, right-click, and go to Change Clip Duration. Go to Frames, and just put one frame. Boom. Now they're all one single frame. Lots of spaces in between, but we're going to change that in a second. We're going to go up to Edit, and we're going to go down to Delete Gaps. Now, there's no key combination for that, but you can make one. Just go into... So when I hit that, it changes it all. It just drops all of them down, as you can see. But if you needed to make a key combination, you just go to Keyboard Customizations. You go into Delete Gaps there, and then just give it a key customization and save it. Okay. That way you can do things pretty quickly. So now you can see all of these are just single frame images. Nice little squirrels and that sort of thing. And squirrely people. So now when I export, I can go to my deliver page. In the deliver page, I can export through a custom export. So I'll give it a file name, demo images. It really doesn't matter. You can change it to whatever you wish. Set them up for where you wanted them to go. And then you go down to the format that you want. So you have quite a few in here to choose from. We're going to just go to JPEG. JPEG has either 420, 422, or 440, which of course is your highest chromatic information. And but standard JPEG, most people are going to get away with just that. The key is choose what you wish, and your timeline resolution is going to be whatever you set the timeline resolution up in the beginning. So if you drag an image that's 4032 by 3024 into the timeline, it'll ask you, do you want to change the timeline? And it'll make it usually to that resolution. If not, you create a timeline. I can go through that and show you that if you need. Frame rate here doesn't really matter. So even if it's 60 frames per second, doesn't matter. We're going to export in, and each one of these is one frame, a single frame. So you're not going to get a large amount of images here. Quality, you've got different compression levels for the JPEG. And again, I'm just going through something here. You can set it to however you wish. I'm going to go to Add to Render Queue. If I zoom in on this keyboard, you have your in and your outs, which you can change. So if I only wanted to go so far, I can set my in point here rather than all the way at the beginning. But that's an option for you. I'm going to Add to Render Queue right there. I'm going to render it all. Boom. Does it like that really quickly. My stills export. So here's the export of the images that I just did. And you can see they're all nice and exported. So that works really well. That way you can use the timeline like that and create them as a single frame, change their duration to single frame, delete the gaps, and use your deliver page to deliver it in a variety of formats. And I hope that helped you. Anybody else who has a question regarding that, I can certainly fine-tune that a little bit more. But otherwise, those are some basic, simple ones. I hope you are having a great time in your creative explorations. And I'm sorry I haven't been here in a while. Life took me by the toes and swung me around a bit. So I'm back, though. And I hope you're doing well. And my best to you and your work. We'll be right back.